Students, the next topic is the suspension bridge in theory of structure 1. Suspension bridges are a very wonderful solution for the larger gaps and also a good looking engineering structure. The suspension bridges normally are made where on the gauges, meaning by that the gaps which they are covering or the span which they are covering have very very larger depths, and constructing too many of piers is not economical. Then we go for the suspension bridges or the cable stayed bridges. Now here is a side view of a suspension bridge. It has necessarily two towers. These are the, say, towers on which cable is hung, on which the bridge is suspended. Let's give you the parts. This is tower. This is suspension cable. Suspension cable. And this one is known as anchor cable. These vertically supporting cables are known as suspenders. Suspenders. And this portion, which is carrying the road bed, is known as deck. These are the major parts of the suspension bridge. Of course, the cable passing over the tower, this is known as pulley or roller. Pulley or roller arrangement over there on which the cable is passing over. Normally, the requirement given to the engineer in case of analysis is that you are given a structure and you are required to analyze, and over here of course the main element of the suspension bridge is the cable which is supporting whole of the structure. So the major problem or the first problem is that how to find out tension in the cable, because cables are only meant for taking the tension. So let's see that how do we go about it. Having known the parts of the suspension bridge, now let's see that if all of this deck is loaded with a uniform load, that it is carrying a uniformly distributed load on complete of the deck, then say given any value to this, or say giving numerical values, because you are quite comfortable in comprehending the numerical values. Say if this is 500 meters span suspension bridge and it has, say, 2 kilonewtons per meter of the uniformly distributed load on its deck, then requirement can be that please find out or determine the tension in the main cable, in the suspension cable. Now how to do that? Of course, these towers will have vertical reactions due to loads to which bridge is subjected to. So let's mark all those unknowns that it has to have a vertical reaction over here. Say if this is AB and a horizontal reaction over here in outward direction. Same is the case on the second spot as well. And if we ignore the weight of the cables and we just consider the UDL over here, then of course the vertical reactions shall be that whole of the load divided by 2, half of the load shall be supported over here and half of the load shall be supported over here. So 2 kN multiplied by 500, say this is VA if this spot is A and this is say taken as B, then vertical reaction at A can be given as 500 multiplied by 2 divided by 2 is equal to 500 kilonewtons. So on both the spots the vertical reaction shall be 500 kilonewtons. Over here as well 500 kilonewtons. Whenever a suspension bridge shall be given to you, another value, that is what is the maximum sag of the cable, suspension cable, shall also be given to you, and it is normally called dip. That is that this value, that how much is sag over here, that is dip, say it is over here, it is say, let's say 10 meters of dip is there, and we are now required to find out the suspension cable tension. So if we make a free body diagram of this much portion only, over here there can be a force in this direction, that is we say T minimum, because if we apply sigma Fy is equal to 0 to half of the bridge, then the upward force sigma Fy is equal to 0, half of the upward force at this spot is negated by the downward force over here. So the only force acting over here at the lowest point shall be a horizontal force, which will be equal and opposite to this one. So we can find out this, say B X or reaction in the X direction at the spot. How can we do that? Just taking moment over here while considering the free body diagram of this one. So it will be, if we take, if this point is C, then taking moment at C is equal to 0, and taking all the clockwise moments as positive. Now please concentrate over here. This Bx with this moment arm of 10 meters is trying to rotate C in the clockwise direction. So Bx multiplied by 10 minus this vertical reaction and moment arm
That is 500 into 250, half of the span, is equal to 0, meaning by that BX is equal to 500 into 250 divided by 10, which will be 0.0125 kilonewtons. So BX over here is 12500 kilonewtons.
Also, please note that horizontal reaction is greater than, much greater than the vertical reaction. So, if we consider whole of the structure as a free body diagram, there is only one other place where a horizontal force can be resisted, and that is horizontal reaction at the spot A. So, this is also equal and opposite to the BX. So, we have found this as 12500 kilonewtons over here. Hence, we have found all the four reactions, and now we are comfortably placed to find the tension in the suspension cable. If you just imagine at any of the spot, that over here, if these two components are to be accommodated over here in this cable, so this cable, which is in tension like this, must be having two components which will be equal and opposite to the reaction at the tower. And if we know both the components of the tension in the cable, then we can find out tension in the cable, that is tension in the cable say suspension cable is equal to 500 square plus 1250 square under root. And answer to this effect is, let's calculate. It is 500 square plus 12500 square, and taking under root of this is 12509.99, or say it is 12510 kilonewtons. So that is the tension in the cable and now we can choose for this particular bridge a cable which can resist this much of tension. So that is how we analyze a suspension bridge cable for the internal force being developed due to the UDL on the deck. Thank you.